Okay. Here we have the vegan cashew cream from Humble Woofer. First, you fill up the dry cashew pieces, dry and raw, into a 6-quart. If you fill that 6-quart up with 4 quarts, and then fill the rest up with filtered water, you will then be able to drain them and rinse them into this strainer and thus be ready to make said cashew cream. You will also need a pint. You can use anything. They're always clean, you don't have to check them. This is what we will use to scoop these into here. Besides that, you'll need a little bit of sauerkraut juice, or kimchi, or ferment, some coconut water, salt, and nutritional yeast. Yeast nutritional. I like the large flake, but the small flake will do. Coffee, if you will. Very optional. This also optional. The last ingredient. We find a little bit of lava lamp in there. Let that go a little longer. It'll be ready by the time we need it. That's hot water, by the way. Alright, here we go. First, you take a two cup. It's kind of like a pint, you know, 16 ounces. That's a little empty, so when we do the half, we'll go a little full. Because this is full, I just spilled some. Cashews are very expensive. So that's roughly 3 cups, 1.5 of these. Then we take a teaspoon of both the nutritional yeast and the salt. Then we fill up the blender with both the liquids we have over here. You want to fill it up till it's just peaking. Cashews are just peaking like that. This has a little bit of solids on the top, but that's fine. It's all good. Then cover your project and blend your project. Watch your settings. And that is a successful blender load into a sperm tensile as such. Put into a 12 quart. You make about 8 quarts, so it's just easier to mix it and pour it when from a 12 quart because it has a corner instead of a bowl which doesn't have a corner. Eventually you're going to put these into quarts. You don't really have to scrape it this much. You're just going to keep doing load after load, but the more you get in there, the easier it is. Leave this guy here. And we go again. Sometimes I like to wipe the rim a little bit, or you can, you know, make sure your hands are clean and get a little tester. Make sure everything's good. I always have a wet rag, but, you know, give it a little wipe on the outside at least. And that's it. Repeat. Repeat steps 3 through 12. See, it's a little short there again, so a little more than half. Something more like that. Well, we'll see. measure this. I just kind of dump it, and you're going to use this whole jar for the amount of cashews we have here. So eventually it'll all be in here, and we'll whisk it all together and make sure it tastes good. The only wild card really is this. Make sure this isn't too old. I wouldn't use it after 3 or 4 days. You know, it really only lasts like 10 days in the coconut whip as far as I'm concerned, but that's just me. So then, dump in here. Pizza! This might be a little better cashew making music. Sorry about that. So again, 1.5 of these. Doesn't have to be exact, but if you do any more, you're gonna have trouble. Sneak as much as this as possible. You really want it to be as thick as possible, so I think everybody peeking out like that, like the water's there, you can see it, liquid, not water. I try not to use water, but you could see what we're working with there. We'll see how that works. That might be too many cashews. So this is the byproduct of making the coconut whipped cream. This comes from the can. But, you know, that's probably going to run out. And if this runs out too, then I'll just go right over here and grab one of these. Also coconut water. You know, I usually only use one, maybe two at the most. And this really benefits, especially once it gets to here. You'll see. All right, so that's pretty much the base of it. We'll watch this one from up here. The base of it. All right, here we go. Start on zero. Slowly crank. Thank you. One thing I do want to mention, when the blender is running, it's heating up in here. So these long blends, this stuff's pretty hot. I mean, it needs to cool. Otherwise, when it goes into the container, it's going to be steamy. You put a lid on it, it doesn't cool right away. And we've had some mold grow where that steamy greenhouse effect is happening, so just be careful. I'm going to go ahead and scrape this with my other hand. I guess I could do this. So I think that's pretty good. Basically, I'm going to do that same thing through all these cashews. How many blender loads it is, but it usually works out pretty good. And then I'll put this in the walk-in, let it cool. Or you could put it, if you're in a real hurry, you can break it down into those corks and then put those in the walk-in with the lid off. Either way, it's up to you. This is hot, you know? It's actually not that bad. Some of those blender loads are not that long. What that last one was, it was really thick. And you want thick vegan cashew cream. Vegan cream cheese. Vegan CC. Whatever we call it here. But this is it. I'd like to thank Christina O. for showing me her Mouskowitz ways with the blender lean. Also like to thank Brett for making all this possible. Our sponsor, Spectrum. And Tempera for her patience. And Jazzy for her organization. And all the little humblers. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.